the whole plant is the medicine that nature provided, and it's the best medicine.
It's truly amazing the number of conditions that respond favorably to cannabis. The number one condition is pain. Cannabis is useful in relieving people's pain. It's particularly effective in relieving pain from connective tissue disorders, from arthritis, from fibromyalgia, from systemic lupus, from reflex sympathetic dystrophy, a whole host of conditions that we don't really understand very well. People seem to get good relief from cannabis. People are able to decrease the amount of opiates that they're taking, and in some instances to stop taking opiates entirely for pain control. The first modern research that Whistler, who was prominent around the turn of the 19th to the 20th century, wrote the first textbook of internal medicine, and in that textbook he said that cannabis was the most effective medication for the treatment of migraine headaches. And I certainly have a number of people with migraines who get substantial relief or even prevention of their migraines by consumption of cannabis. Other conditions that commonly respond favorably to marijuana include depression. It helps people with sleep. It helps their appetite. It's also very good in treating GI symptoms, nausea, diarrhea. It's excellent for treating Crohn's disease. We did a little
study. 3/4 of us think it ought to be legalized if it's for medicinal purposes. It's a very different number if you take that away. Now, here's how medical marijuana could affect the brain and the body. And patients who use it say it works better and in ways that no other medicine works for them. I've got a little animation that I hope bring this home. So let's say you're having aches and pains. It could be in your belly, in your limbs, in your legs. It doesn't frankly matter. When you smoke marijuana, you inhale its gases. Those gases go into your lungs and they fill your lungs. And when they fill your lungs, they pass a chemical called THC, those little green dots, into the bloodstream, which then is passed throughout the body, getting all kinds of places. Let's look into the nervous system, where so many of the aches and pains are located. And just quickly reminding you that nerves talk to each other. When they do that, they release chemicals. Those little pink balls come across and they allow one nerve to talk to another to send signals of pain. What marijuana does, that THC chemical is able to get into those areas where the nerves talk. And these little green balls literally plug up the connectors between the nerves. So they slow down or inhibit or completely stop the ability of nerves to talk to each other and transmit pain, and that brings you relief. So here's the big question. What's it like to live with the kind of pain that patients say is only relieved by a drug they cannot easily get? Talk show host Montel Williams knows firsthand.
Montel Williams is an authentic American success story. He grew up on the rough side of Baltimore, then rose to become an Emmy award-winning talk show host, best-selling author, and entrepreneur. But 12 years ago, his life changed dramatically when Williams was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis.
I have been living with neuropathic pain in my lower extremities, my face and my side, 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, period. Doesn't go away.
Williams decided to use his celebrity to launch a very public crusade to find a cure for MS and legalize medical marijuana, a treatment he says has saved him from the crippling effects of his disease.
The only thing that has kept me a contributing member of the society for the last 10 years is that I've used marijuana every single day.
His advocacy for medical marijuana has put Williams in the spotlight and under the scrutiny of the law. In January, Williams was arrested at the Milwaukee airport and later fined for possessing a pipe used for smoking marijuana. But his arrest has not silenced him.
Marijuana may not work for everyone, but what it has done for me is it's given me my life back. A life like everybody else.
Please welcome Montel Williams. He's a very inspirational man, and I've seen firsthand the pain that you endure all the time that you're awake and probably even when you're asleep. What's it like to feel like a patient but to be treated like a criminal when you try to help yourself?
See, what's really kind of crazy about this is that, you know, I spent 22 years in the United States military in two branches of our service. the Marine Corps and the Navy, supporting and defending this Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic. I just came back from Afghanistan 2 weeks ago, went over and visited our troops there in the battlefield to make sure that somebody recognized that we still remember them. So, you know, I feel like this. If I'm defending this Constitution for all of us, why do I not have the right to the same rights that this government has given other people? Because I'm going to start right at the beginning with this. Today, you're doing something today that nobody's attempted to do, and that's tell the truth. Let's do that today, because I say this only to say to you that our federal government for the last 22 years has been distributing marijuana in a special program through the University of Mississippi, starting with 20 patients. It's now down to 4 that are still alive. 16 of them have passed away. Every 17th of the month, our government sends out a canister of marijuana that we grow. Your taxpayer dollars pay for. So when you say, what does it feel like to be a criminal? I feel like if I put my life on the line and our government says it's okay to give it to 4 people, how dare you look me in the face and tell me I don't have a right to be pain-free? So come on, guys. You know, I'm not asking for anything special.
One love.
So when the man comes, there will be.